for Chris Burns. You asked about this bridge. I actually had it on about four or five different guitars. This is an Epiphone Special One, just $100. I got it delivered to the house for $100 last summer or so. Just a basic Epiphone bass model. Didn't do nothing but change pickups around. I got two bridge pickups in it. And then I put this on there. So the adjustments on this, when you put it on, it's really easy. Anything with a LP bridge, it's really easy. It's all lined up. You just take the one off, pop this one on there. You got to put your little pegs in there that go with this. And then you tighten the little screws down there, not all the way. You tighten them down so you got a little bit of play in there. It's got to have a little play so it wobbles. And then you tighten your strings up. And you just over here, you have a stop block here you can bring up. I don't know if you can see it from the camera, but there's a stop block here. Comes up, and you can stop it from coming back as far as you want, or you can let it go free flow. And then the same in the front, it has two little pegs on either side here, Allen bolts, that you can bolt them down, and they will keep it from rocking forward or bring the front up a little bit if you need it. Played with that a little bit. But the adjustment of the springs, the strings and everything is the same as a regular Floyd. Everything's the same there, locks and adjustments. This is different. There's a spring in there, and your little adjustment is in the back here, and that adjusts the spring there, which keeps you tension on either way you want it. So once you get it on there and get it towards your tuning, whatever you're doing, you're going to look at it, and you're going to pull it down, pull it up, and you see where it stops, and you want to adjust that till it stops right in the same spot each time, and then tune, and then do it again, and do it again until it's set. It does take a couple times, because when you set it, you're going to pull it out of tune. So you're going to tune it up a little bit, and you're going to have to set it again. So it takes a little bit, but it's once you get it good, it sets nice. This one works good on this. It works better on a flat guitar. I had it on a Epiphone Studio, and because of the little curve there, it just didn't sit on there right. I had it on some other guitars, too. This is the one that sat on the best so far. Yeah, this is the one that sat on so bad. It's flat, though. It's a $100 guitar, so I put a $300-some-odd bridge on a $100 guitar, but I like it. You know, I've had it on a few things, anything with a bridge. I even put a LP bridge on a couple of them to check them out on there. I had it on my V for a while. It worked great, very good on a V because the V's flat, too. I don't know which one it's going to stay on. I can't afford another one. But, yeah, Floyd Rose FRX. Pretty cool. It takes a little bit of learning to do. I've never been good with a Floyd until I got this and started studying on it. You know, and then I can kind of adjust the other ones. But the first time I ever adjusted one, I had to take the guitar back to the factory, sent it back to Don Dillon's, and they sent it back to the factory. Because I fucked it up. Something like that. So, yeah, it's pretty cool, man. I like the guitars you're making, Chris. Anybody listening, check out Chris Burns' guitars, man. They are badass. I'll leave a link in the explanation of this video. And you got to check them out. They are so cool. There's no in the middle. You can see through them. Freaking awesome. The Explorer that you showed the other day, dude, that would look really good right up there next to my Explorer. So that's the Floyd Rose FRX. They're on back order, last I knew. They got gold ones, black ones. I came across this one. Scott at Tremolo had it and showed it to me. He knows how I am. I was like, ooh, pretty. A couple days later, I had it. Not even been that day, but I really wanted to check it out, and I'm glad I did. It's a really cool tool. It takes some adjustment. It's not a typical Floyd because it sits on top. So, I mean, I think it's simpler. It doesn't go through all the springs in the back, but, to each his own. I dig it. Pretty much an adjustment now. unless I change tuning. So I'll play a little bit and then I'm out of here. Woo woo. Working it out. Up your ass. I got a bad chord, so I'm out. Has anybody ever tried to this fucking chord? I don't know if anybody's ever tried two wah pedals. I've got two right down here at my feet. One was a bass pedal and one was a guitar pedal. Two different sounds. Pretty cool, man.